That's good.
The promised melodious wake-up call could use some work, but it's the thought that counts, right?
Good morning, Lakes of the Clouds High.
We've been roused from our bunks for a 7 a.m. breakfast of pancakes, eggs, and bacon. We've just spent the night at the Appalachian Mountain Club's Lakes of the Clouds Hut, and somewhere out there is the summit of Mount Washington. The forecast does not look good.
The winds are going to be around 45 to 60 miles an hour, and the wind chills 15 to 25 degrees later.
Feel the energy just breathing through the room.
But first, the traditional morning skit from our hut crew.
We're going to get our yoga blankets folded up here.
Guests are gently instructed on folding their blankets, packing out their trash.
Pack it on out.
And most importantly, the psychic benefits of generosity.
Ooh, just imagine giving it right over to him, tipping the crew. Is that not a good feeling? Wow.
Speaking of packing out trash, everything at the hut is packed in and out on crew members' backs, more than 1,000 pounds of food a week.
Everyone packs, yeah. We all share that responsibility no matter what. And everyone's really, really strong and super amazing, empowering people that make you feel like you can do it too.
Seeing the weather that awaits us, we can't help but wonder if we should have opted for a plusher bivvy down in the valley, the brand new Glen House Hotel.
And the same reason that it's a great location for a hotel today is the reason why a hotel was built here back in the 1850s. It's this unbelievable view.
For more than a century, the family that owns the Mount Washington Auto Road also had a hotel here at the base of the mountain. But for the last 50 years, the Glen stood vacant.
We've kind of come back to our hospitality roots now after an absence of over 50 years without a hotel on the property.
Situated right next to the company's Great Glen Trails, the hotel features state-of-the-art energy features like geothermal heating.
Because unlike a lot of hotels, we weren't building this hotel to turn it over in 5 or 7 years and sell it for a profit. This is going to be part of the family legacy.
But it's finally time to face the music. The longer we put it off, the more likely we'll face those ugly wind chills.
Oh.
Yesterday's sunshine is but a memory. After all, the weather gods giveth.
And the weather gods taketh away. But there's no Green Line coming. There's no Uber. It's only one way out. And it's hiking.
As we follow the cairns through this prehistoric world with horizontal rain stinging our faces, we can't help wondering why we did this. Then we recall the words Corey Bergeron from Florida shared with us back at the hut.
The big thing for me is discovering a place that I know very few people have had the fortitude to go and see firsthand. There is a mystique to these mountains, a beauty to them that is beyond a picture or a video that you can take. And believe me, there is no camera that's gonna pick up that panorama that's all the way around you. I wanna experience it firsthand, and I hold on to those things.
It was a cold, wet slog that day we left the hut, but we made it to the summit of Mount Washington, where we caught a ride down. We got a taste of why Mount Washington gets that worst weather in the world label, even in the early summer. But on a serious note, the week we hiked last year, there were 2 rescues and tragically 1 fatality. So no matter the season, that mountain is not a joke. Be prepared if you do decide to go. And that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. I'm Anthony Everett. Have a good evening. Hope to see you back here again tomorrow night. Hope you're staying safe and healthy.